In the past, I noticed there was a little confusion regarding the Mi Notebook Air and the Windows license. So, let's bust a myth. The digital license pre-installed is perfectly valid for Windows 10 Home, for every language, including English, but it's necessary to make a clean installation of the OS and drivers. In this video, I'll guide you step by step from powering on the Mi Notebook Air to the complete reinstallation of Windows, correctly activated and with all drivers. I tested this method on the 2017 12-inch model, but changing the drivers is the same procedure for the 2017 model, the 13-inch and the Pro model. You only need an internet connection and a USB drive big at least 8GB to use for the installation, that's all. Once you turn on the Mi Notebook Air for the first time, you'll see the screen. Follow my lead to reach the desktop. Save from some options such as accepting the user's license, it doesn't matter what options you pick, but I suggest connecting the notebook to the Wi-Fi network as to properly activate the license on your computer. Once you get to the desktop, my suggestion is to quickly change the keyboard layout to English, so you have a conformity between the keys and what you type. Otherwise, once you type commands or addresses, you'll have issues with Chinese characters. You just need to go to the settings menu from the start menu, picking the international options, that is the icon with the clock and the characters. You can also choose to set the hour to the right time zone, and in the left bar, choose the second option. Press the plus button and choose English, USA. Select then English, USA, and press the first button to make it default language. Select then the other voice, Chinese, and press the left button, remove, so you only have the keyboard in English. Now, an optional step. If you want, you can extract the license key to write it down in case you should lose it. Open a command prompt by going to the search bar, typing CMD, then right-click on the result and choose the first voice that means run as administrator. Press OK on the first button and type the command you can find in the video's description to show the product key that you can write down. It's not necessary as the license is preserved during the reinstallation, but you can write it down for extra safety. Let's move on. Download the Windows Media Creation tool from the link you can find in the description or by searching on Google. For now, you only need this and your USB drive. We will install the drivers at a second time. Follow then the procedure I'll show you on screen. Once loaded, accept the license contract. You'll find yourself with two options. The first one is used to update the computer to the latest Windows version. We obviously need the second one. Deselect the checkbox so that you can change the Windows language and choose the desired one. I put Italian, but you can choose whichever you want. Then, the Windows edition, and it's important you choose Windows 10, not N, and neither the last option, which is single language. And the last option asks if you want to install the 32-bit version, the 64-bit one, or both. Choose 64-bit and press Next and the underline button. We then have the option to create a USB support for the installation, or to create an ISO. Select the first option and move on, with our USB drive connected. Confirm with the device letter, in my case it's D, you can check it in the file manager, and press Next. The download of the necessary files will then begin, and then the installation on the USB drive. Once the procedure is finished, press the only button and proceed by turning the PC off. Turn it back on and press F12 during the startup to enter the BIOS. Then select the USB drive from the menu, that is EFI USB device, and press Enter. From now on, the procedure is much simpler, since the menus will be in your preferred language. Press Next, Install, and then I don't have a product key. Be sure to select Windows 10 Home, this is important as other versions won't work, and press Next. Press Personalized, and then select the bigger disk unit, the primary type one labeled with Windows. Be careful during this step and proceed with calm. With the Windows partition selected, press on Format, then OK, and then, always with the partition selected, press Next. Now wait for the installation to proceed. Several reboots will be necessary. After the first setup, you'll be asked to connect to a Wi-Fi network, so do it. Select the setting you prefer, create an account, and go on. A Windows update will be prompted, but for now we can postpone it by pressing on Not Now. Once installed, we must install the drivers. You can find the link to the official Xiaomi site with the drivers for every model in the description. Download the ones that are the most suitable. At this point, you must extract the downloaded zip file and then extract every single driver, and then run the installation file, usually setup.exe, and reboot when prompted. It's an easy yet boring procedure. Once you finish, you'll have installed all the drivers properly. These are, however, original drivers that are not updated. If you want to update them to a latest version, use a tool such as Driver Booster, downloadable for free, which will search for drivers updated and will install them automatically. Another optional procedure if you want to set up the manufacturer's info is to download OEM Configurator and fill in the info that are shown here, that you can find also in the description. Reboot and check if they are shown correctly. Once this last procedure is finished, you'll be done. Check if Windows is correctly activated and enjoy your new Mi Notebook Air. If you want the original Xiaomi wallpaper, you can find the link in the description. Thanks for watching, I hope you find this tutorial useful, and until next time!